Good morning, everyone. Today, I would like to share with everyone what is the Six Paramita. The Six Paramita actually is a quality conduct of being Bodhisattva. As we already learned a lot of Bodhisattva story, why those Bodhisattva is able to become Bodhisattva? Actually, they start just like an ordinary human first. But they practice Six Paramita, generosity, precepts, tolerance, diligence, meditation, great wisdom. These Six Paramita actually we also can categorize as a benefit others and the self-cultivate and the liberation. So these are very important because without these Six Paramitas practice, we cannot actually practice starting from ordinary human practitioners to Bodhisattva. Without accumulate all the quality and the conduct of a Bodhisattva, we were never able to attain the Buddhahood. So some people must be very curious about why we should attain the Buddhahood. But actually, Buddha already told us, all the sentient beings, including you, including myself, including the squirrel in the forest, they all have equivalent the same of the Dharmakaya. This Dharmakaya, the Buddha nature, is already within with us all the time. But we never realize that, we never discover that, because our daily mind activity, our daily behavior is all full with ignorance, the judgment, attachment, so could not actually practice all the virtue of Bodhisattva. So that's why we need practice. And actually how to practice that is starting from being a good practitioner, as a human practitioner. So we need actually starting from taking a refuge vow, become a student of the Buddha, and want to make inspiration wishes to learn from the Buddha. And once we become the student of the Buddha, take a refuge, and we need actually taking the precepts with the five precepts. With these five precepts that will helping us not hurting others, not harming other beings. Let's already cover the first two paramita, generosity and the precepts. Generosity actually is easy to relate. You can giving by joy, giving the food, and releasing other beings' suffering by not killing the animals. So the generosity precepts, these two paramita actually is benefit others. That's a very important practice of these two paramita. The third paramita is tolerance. Why this is so important? Because when we practice the Bodhisattva path, sometimes even though we want to liberate the beings suffering, we still may be mistreated. So if we cannot practice the tolerance, still continuous walk on this cultivation path of being a Bodhisattva, sometimes you will just give up because all the challenges we faced. The fourth paramita is diligence. The diligence is means we cannot get lazy. We need always continuous and diligently to having all the being in our heart, practice our great compassion, raising the true bodhicitta. That bodhicitta is driving us to attain the Buddhahood. Because of this great compassion, because of this bodhicitta, we will never give up on any being. So diligence also important. So the tolerance and diligence, these are self-cultivate. And on the fifth paramita is samadhi practice, is meditation paramita. This meditation paramita and the sixth paramita wisdom, they are interconnected. Because without actual self-reflect, meditate to attain samadhi, our mind cannot actually instill and the peace mind. We cannot transform our ordinary mind to the bodhisattva mind. So meditation and the paramita wisdom is always cooperating together. This wisdom paramita means maha paramita wisdom, means enlightened one's wisdom. It means Buddha's wisdom. This wisdom includes selfless, great compassion, bodhicitta, all the virtues we described earlier, including the six paramitas virtue. They are all embodied together. So without this, actually the six paramita wisdom cannot actually manage rest of the five paramita. So this six paramita wisdom is a main boss to command the rest five paramita, because without full realized view of the emptiness, you cannot fulfill actually the complete bodhisattva path, because bodhisattva path is not only one turn of life, it's infinity turn of life. That's a lot of hardship, a lot of difficult challenge. Without these six paramita, the six quality of practice bodhicitta path, we cannot become a bodhisattva. Without having this bodhisattva's true virtue, we cannot actually attain the Buddhahood. So that is also depend on origination. They are all depend on one and the other, cannot be separately existence. So that is a very important view to actually practice the six paramita. And I wish by ending of my sharing today, you also can realize from an ordinary human's practitioner to bodhisattva, actually the key to open this gate is bodhicitta, is great compassion. I wish by ending of my sharing, you have more knowledge about this whole path of attain the Buddhahood, how this look like. I hope next time you will join me for another sharing. Thank you.